This is the Strat-O-Matic Baseball Excel 1970-73 Carryover League. Brought to you by the Shrimp Trawler YouTube channel.
Welcome back, baseball fans, to the summer 70-73 Carryover League. We are back into divisional rounds of seven, featuring tonight the National League Mountain Division, Las Vegas and Arizona. This division, of course, four expansion teams, which guarantees one of them will make the playoffs of the eight expansion teams we have in this era, joining the 24 traditional Major League franchises. 2 years ago, Colorado won the division. Last year, Las Vegas won the division. This year, Arizona has gotten off to a hot start. However, they're starting to stumble, and this division is starting to jumble back to mediocrity and somewhere in the middle. Let's take a look at this series as we open up in Las Vegas. Arizona sends their ace, Reggie Cleveland, against Blue Moon Odom. It's a good baseball game. That's something you get with these expansion teams. They're very close. They're fun games. There's some good players here. Not necessarily Hall of Famers, but Hall of Very Gooders all over the place, you can say. Three runs in the bottom of the seventh topples Reggie Cleveland and Chris Short, and Vegas wins 4-3. Then, in game two, can Arizona get a split on the road and claim home field? And the answer is no, they cannot. Ray Culp, the ace of Las Vegas, beats Jim Willoughby by that same score, 4-3. And the way it was done, Arizona gets a couple runs in the second on some singles. In the sixth inning, Art Shamsky, a two-run homer, ties it. Then Arizona retakes the lead in the seventh on a sac fly, bottom of the inning, a solo job by Jim Nettles. Culp and Willoughby are determined to go the distance. Three up and three down in the ninth inning for Culp. Good for him. Jim Willoughby, first pitch he throws to John Bacabella. Over the wall. John Bacabella, walk off. Champagne and probably $2 steaks at Circus Circus for John Bacabella as Vegas wins 4-3 for the second time. So, game three. In Arizona, must-win situation. You certainly don't want to go down 0-3, particularly when you had such a great start this year and you're in danger of throwing it all away. Well, let's go take a look at what happened in Game 3. Game 3 in Arizona. Another one-run game, folks. Ken Brett versus Juan Pizarro. Top of the third, Ken Berry, two-run homer. Top of the fifth, Ron Hansen, solo homer. Vegas up 3-0 in this game. In the bottom of the sixth inning, they get to Ken Brett for a couple runs here on a double with two out. But they put men on in the seventh and eighth, do not bring them home. And Las Vegas has won three straight in this series, making a virtual tie between Arizona, Vegas, and Colorado in a jumble, a couple games over 500. Three games to nothing. Vegas on top. They need one more win in the series, and the once red-hot Arizona Diamondbacks are the stone-cold Arizona Diamondbacks. I don't know how cold it gets in Arizona, but you get the idea. So game four in a must-win situation today. Oh, it's a tough one, too. Vegas is going to send Woody Freeman out there, folks. My goodness, Arizona, you are in trouble. Woody was 10-3 with a 2.05 ERA in 114 innings. Did that for the Tigers on that American League East title-winning team. And Reggie Cleveland will pitch again for Arizona on short rest because they need him to. Let's get started from Joshua Tree with Graham Parsons and the Fallen Angels playing in the background. Leading off for Lost Wages is Ken Berry. 2-5 for Berry is a grounder to short. Tommy Davis, 5-10, 1-3 fly ball off Cleveland is a fly ball. And Art Shamsky, 1-7, a single. Ron Hansen, 2-3, grounds to short. Bottom of first, Chris Arnold, 54, lines of first. We have seen Woody Fryman pitch on YouTube this year, and he has a shutout. So my goodness, folks, he's having a great year, is Woody. Brock Davis, 2-6, is a base hit. Philippe Alou, 2-12, is a, oh boy, ground ball, short A, plus injury. They lose their first baseman, Philippe Alou. Well, who else can play first for this squad? And the answer is find the first baseman before the... Okay. I guess Dalton Jones will have to play first base. There you go. Oh, boy. Not the start zone I wanted. Jim Nettles leads off the top of the second inning. 47 is a K. John Bacabella, 2-6, base hit, hero of the game, 2-hero. Ted Kubiak, 1-7, field of choice, and with 2 outs, A-Rod, the original one, short X. This is Popovich, a 3-E-30, and he makes the play. Good start for Cleveland. Roger Fried, 2-12, short. George Thomas, 1-8, base hit. Don Hahn, 66, skies to left. And with 2 outs, Stevie Ray Braun, 4-4 off of Woody, is double 1-19. That is a double. You have second and third with 2 outs, and it's Paul Popovich. Oh boy, folks. 2-12 is strikeout plus another injury. We're running out of Diamondbacks. Not a good day for the Snakes. The Mongoose have them today. We lost a shortstop, we lost the first base, but we're running out of guys here. We gotta come up with a shortstop here. Who can play short for this team? Well, I guess Stevie Ray Braun's gotta play short. George Thomas can play third. Easy Ed Herman will come in. Yeah. So Thomas goes from DH to third, Braun goes from third to short, and Ed Herman will go to DH. Ooh, yeesh. Not a good omen at all for Arizona. Bad news, bad luck thus far. Ron Hodges leads off in the third for Vegas. 48, single 1-17, is a 17 and a single. Ken Berry, 6-10, catcher's card. We still have Casanova catching. Good defensive catcher, 2-E-6. And we get a foul out. That's good. Tommy Davis, 65, center C, and with 2 outs. Art Shamsky, 59 off of Cleveland, triple 1-4, single dot dot. He gets the triple 1-4. Oh my goodness, folks. And Vegas has the lead, and you can say they are 21 outs away from a sweep in Joshua Tree. Ron Hansen, the batter. 64 is ball four. 2 on, 2 outs for Jim Nettles. 1-2 fouls to the catcher. Bottom of the third, it is Paul Casanova. I want to say Raul Casanova. That might be his son, right? Maybe. 32 fouls to the catcher. Chris Arnold, 311. You gotta be kidding me, folks. Let's take a look at the card. You know what? Let's take a look at three cards. We're going to skip back to Roger, to Philippe Alou's card against a lefty and look at 212, and you'll see ground ball short A plus injury. Thank you very little. Then we're going to take a look at Paul Popovich's card, also rolled a 212. Popovich here, that's a strikeout plus an injury. And for variation, Chris Arnold just rolled a 311. Fly ball to right field B, plus an injury. Devastating, folks, and this is what you hope doesn't happen with a 12-man roster, with a 20-man roster. Three injuries in three innings for a team that's down 3-0. So, we know one thing. Jim Lytle, the last guy on the bench, is coming in. He'll play center field. Let's see. The center fielder, Han, will play left field. And we need a second baseman. Who can play second base on this squad? Braun's at short. And Dalton Jones will play second. So now I just need a first baseman. This is hideous. George Thomas at third. Stevie Braun at short. And Dalton Jones at second. So which guy gets the play? You know, first base isn't that hard, folks. You just kind of stand there with a glove and, yeah. And we nominate Ed Herman. Ed Herman will be the first baseman because he's a catcher. A lot of times catchers play first base, so he doesn't actually play first base this year, but he will now. So the outfield will officially be Lytle in center. Gotta get this all set up here. Don Hahn in left, and Roger Fried in right, which leaves Brock Davis as the designated hitter, and he's up. Brock Davis, the new designated hitter. I gotta put the fly out for him. 56 flies the right field. Woody Fryman's given up three hits. Otherwise, if he hadn't given up any, he'd be a great candidate for a no-hitter at this point. Down a run with six frames to go and losing a third of your offense is not a good look for Vegas. Top of the fourth, John Bacabella. 6'10", catcher's card. Casanova's still catching, makes the play. Kubiak, 33, pops to second. And original A-Rod, Aurelio Rodriguez, 6'11", short X. This is Braun, right? Stevie Ray Braun, I guess 4048, I'm going to guess if I had to. Yes, 4048, looking for a play, and he makes the play. You see the four there? GBB means that's on the fielding rating, not the E-rating. So that is a ground out. Great defensive play by the new shortstop, Steve Braun. Bottom of the fourth. And it is the new number three hitter, Dalton Jones, against the lefty. 56, flies to right. Roger Fried. 54, pops to first. George Thomas, 64, bounced to third X. This is A-Rod, a 1E19 at third base, and he boots the ball there. They still have some life. It's Don Hahn. 1-8's a walk, two on, two outs. Big at-bat here for Stevie Ray Braun. Made that great defensive play in the top of the inning. Chance to be a hero here for the Diamondbacks. Let's take a look at Stevie Ray's card. Great little player here. Nice little career, utility player, pinch hitter. Played for the Twins in the American League. Played for the Cardinals in the National League. Made a lot of many stops. Useful guy, on base, versatile, pinch hitter, that kind of thing. The pitch to Stevie Ray Braun, 56 off of Woody, is a fly ball to right. Woody Fryman, three hitter, through four. Let's go to the fifth. Ron Hodges, 2-6, single, 1-9, lines out. Ken Berry, 45, pops out. Tommy Davis, 5-10 off of the Cleveland card. It's that homer 1-3, fly ball, and he misses it. Rolls a 9. Cleveland survives. It's just one zip. Let's pause a moment for station identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
We go to the bottom of the fifth, Arizona, and in a crisis situation. They started the year 5-0, had the best record in baseball coming out of the blocks. Then it's been misfortune since, and they're playing a game with three starters gone after the first three innings, and they've got one of the best lefties in all of baseball, Woody Fryman, in there, and their three bench players are all left-handed and can't hit left-handed pitching whatsoever. They're almost automatic outs. And they are 15 outs away from getting swept. This has all the markings for Arizona to come back and win this game 6-1. So we'll see what happens. So leading off will be Ed Herman. 66 off Fryman pops the second. Paul Casanova. 1-8 is a K. And with two outs, it's Jim Lytle. 55, second C. Oh boy. Top of the sixth, Reggie Cleland. He's got a stiff upper lip this one. Top of the sixth inning. He's got to carry his squad. He is the ace. The only guy who can pitch on 3 days rest. And his team is offensively and defensively devastated. Art Shamsky leads it off. 3-6 is a sky to right. Ron Hansen, 57, is a K. And with two outs, Jim Nettles. 1-5, grounds a second. Reggie Cleveland hanging in there. One run off of four hits through six frames. He's saying, give me a bat. I'll go up there and swing. I know we got guys hurt. I don't care. We're going to win this thing. Bottom of the sixth. Leading off, it'll be Brock Davis. 58. Pops to third. Well, they've rolled on Fryman's card a lot, and there's not a lot there, folks, as you can tell. Dalton Jones, 6'10", short X. Well, this might be your best chance. He's a 4. 4E14, Ron Hansen. No. Missed it. Got out on the E rating. Mr. Dalton Jones. And with two outs, it's Roger Freed. 3-10, K. What also makes this daunting, by the time we get into the 8th and 9th innings, Vegas can pick and choose the lefty-righty matchups they want. Because with Fryman being a lefty, they have Jim Rollins a lefty, and they have three righties in the bullpen. So they can just do the straight platoon and don't have to worry about a pinch hitter. As we go to the top of the 7th, it'll be John Bacabella. 34, grounds are short. Ted Kubiak, 35, was a walk. Aurelio Rodriguez, 2-8, is a 5-4-3 double play. Vegas is falling asleep at the wheel, folks. Just got a run. That's not good. You could score multiple runs without even getting a hit in Strat with some crazy luck. Stretch time here in Arizona. We are listening to The Burritos, of course, Flying Burrito Brothers Anthology, 69-72. And this great comp, once you get past the Gilded Palace of Sin, you got about an extra 20 tunes of unreleased stuff. So yeah, cool stuff here. Tonight the Bottle Let Me Down, 6 days on the Road, Close Up, The Honky Tonks, great stuff. By Graham Parsons and the Fallen Angels. Well, let's get back to the game. Bottom of the seventh. Leading off in the bottom of the seventh, the best hitter on the Diamondbacks. Let's take a look at him, folks. It's George Thomas. George Thomas, a .343 hitter and 99 plate appearances. And boy, George, we really need a spark here to help your D-backs. The pitch to George. 66 off of Woody, another fly ball to left. Don Hahn, 39 is a single. We got a base runner. He is a D stealer, but a 1-14 runner. Stevie Ray Braun, 67 is a K. And with two outs, it's easy Ed Herman. 1-7 is a walk, 2-1. Two outs. It's Paul Casanova. Let's take a look at him just because, well, this could be it, folks. They got two runners on base. Paul Casanova. He's actually better against righties as well, as you can tell just a little bit. So Casanova brings this nice minus two arm to the Diamondbacks, but he also brings a .229 batting average that he had with the Washington Senators in 1970. Big at-bat here for Paul. This could make a huge difference in the overall standings in the Mountain Time Zone playoff hunt, for Pete's sakes. The pitch to Paul Casanova. 4-12, again, off the Woody card, and again an out. Nothing today off the Woody card. And we've rolled on it a lot, if you've been following closely. So as bad as Arizona's luck has been with their injured players not playing, the other part of the problem is they keep rolling off Woody Fryman, and you're not going to find much there. Top of the eighth. Just a 1-0 game. Reggie Cleveland's not going nowhere, or isn't going anywhere. trying to get the double negative to say he's staying in, so you figure that one out. He's staying in. Ron Hodges leads off in the eighth. 2-7 is a K. Ken Berry, the 1-0 center fielder. Always fun to have that guy in the game. 68, single 1-9. It's a base hit. He is a C stealer. Who's Casanova's catching? You're not going anywhere. Tommy Davis, 2-3 is a 5-4-3 double play. Folks, Vegas, if you lose this game, you might regret it, folks, because you've got these guys by the jugular. If you can score like two or three runs, this thing's over, but it's not over. It's just a 1-0 game in the bottom of the eighth. Does Vegas want to bring some defense in? Well, you got Tim Cullen is a rangy 2 second baseman. Jarvis Tatum's a rangy 3 outfielder, so they'll come in. Unfortunately, Cullen will come in for Shamsky. And Tatum will come in for Kubiak. Oh boy. It's a 1-0 game. Bottom of the eighth. Woody Freimas, starter 8. Leading off, Jim Lytle. 55, again, second C. And I do not recall an X. I don't think I've rolled any X's off the Freiman card. It's been automatic out. It's been a remarkable performance in addition to all the misfortune by the Arizona for Freiman. I'm surprised he gave up 3 hits early in this thing. Brock Davis, 6'11". There's an X to left field. Fly ball left X. Jim Nettles, a 2E7. In left field, a 2E7. They do not get it. Fly ball B. That's tough. And with 2 outs, it's Dalton Jones. 34, Dalton. Let's take a look at Dalton Jones' card. Well, not pretty. Well, we kind of knew that by this point, folks. They're not going to be pretty cards. Dalton against the lefty, though. It's some doubles. Hit 220 for the Tigers in 1970. Versatile player, multiple infield spots. 34, double, and 18 gets it. And if they score a run, this thing might go 16 innings. Roger Fried is your batter. Let's take a look at Roger Fried's card. This is your best chance to get a two-run bomb here and win this thing. Roger Fried tempted to bring a righty in, but reality is he has power against righties too, just not as many homers. And Woody Freiman is throwing a shutout. You know, it's hard to... Yeah. Roger Fried, the pitch to Roger. 2-2 is a fly ball to left field. We go to the ninth inning of a 1-0 game. And there's a hush over Diamondback Stadium as their troubled team is really in trouble now. They can't afford to give up anything in the ninth inning. Reggie Cleveland gave up 1 run on this Shamsky triple in the third inning, and not much else at all. Not many hits even. Here's Tim Cullen leading off in the ninth. 1-6 is a sky to center field. Ron Hanson. 47 is a K, and with 2 outs is Jim Nettles. 1-6 is a grounder to third base. Reggie Cleveland, the fans give him an ovation here. They know what the story is. They got to score a run or two in the bottom of the ninth, or they are in trouble in their Mountain Division. They would have blown a 5-0 or a 5-0-1 loss record, best record in baseball for the first start of the season, and not much sense. And again, we got George Thomas, saw his card, the 343 hitter, leading off against Freiman. If they wanted to, they have York for a batter. They could do Roland for a batter. I mean, they could really alternate lefties and righties if you want to start knocking the bats out of guys' hands. George Thomas hits everybody, so it doesn't really matter. And here is the pitch to George Thomas. 1-8 is going to be a base hit. Now, I know Woody Freiman is immaculate, but you have to really start thinking about taking him out and simply knocking the bat out of these platoon players' hands who cannot hit. And they're going to do it. And the reason they're pulling Woody with a shutout is so he can't lose. Puts the leadoff guy on. He's a little ticked off. They're taking him out. But they know why. Because they can knock the bats out of the hands of these guys. We'll start with Roger Hambright. Let's take a look at Roger. Not many on bases against righties for Roger Hambright. And let's take a look at Don Hahn. As you can see, not much on base on this card either. And he's a C-bunter, so you don't even want him to bunt. So Roger Hambright to Don Hahn, runner at first. Can't even pinch run for Thomas. Hahn, 2-9, is a sky to center field. Now you got Stevie Ray Braun and Ed Herman. And I think you're going to go right back to the lefty. And this is Jim Rowland. Let's take a look at Jim. Jim Rowland for the next two batters, and the game continues. Maybe they'll go to York. Against Stevie Ray Braun in the ninth, the runner at first and one out. The pitch to Steve Braun. 39 is a walk. They got a runner in scoring position for Ed Herman. Let's take a look at the Ed Herman card. Boy, you better be glad you're left-handed throwing to him. Guy crushes homers against righties. Still very good player against left-handed pitching. And he is at the plate with runners at first and second and one out. The pitch to Ed Herman. 47 off of Rowland, a single, 1-10. He gets the seventh single and they're loaded with one out. And it's Casanova and Lytle. Oh, if you had a base open and you don't have a base, you need to leave. And you got to leave Rowland in here because you've got bad lefties versus lefties behind Casanova, Lytle, Davis, and Dalton Jones. Only question remains, do you put the infield up or do you leave it back? And the answer is, when we look at Casanova's card, he's got ground ball Bs predominantly on his card. So they're going to bring the infield up. A base hit on the plus is a walk-off in this situation. And Paul Casanova, 0-3, no bigger moment than now, with one out in the bottom of the ninth, will bat against Rowland with the bases loaded, one out. The pitch to Paul Casanova. 4-4, Paul Casanova off of Jim Rowland walks the game off with a two-run single. Off the Rowland card, it's over, and Arizona's incredible comeback with nothing whatsoever for an offense. Vegas blows the game. There's only 1-0. They blew it by not scoring, and they blew it again by blowing the matchups. They had the righty versus righty, and the lefty could not get any lefty out at all. He walks Braun, he gives up a hit to Herman, and a two-run single, and Jim Rowland's the closer for Vegas. The Vegas closer just blew the save. I have 2/3 there, he didn't get anybody out. Reggie Cleveland does get the win. Boy, if this really was traditional MLB, this would be a huge momentum swing for Arizona, getting a win like this. 2-1 final. Let's do the box. That is a huge win for this division. We'll just put it that way, be nice about it. Two walks, four strikeouts, a nice, solid performance by Reggie Cleveland. Hambright got his guy out. But Jim Rowland put the goat horns on. All you had to do was get a batter or two out, and you couldn't do a thing. He gives up two hits, a run, a walk. He takes the loss. Woody Fryman has to stew in the bench with a no decision, giving up just one run. Walk two, struck out four. 1-009, 0-108 and a third. 2-8-1-5. 2-8-1-5, 2-4-3-4, 2-4-2-4. Well, congratulations, Diamondbacks. You may have kind of saved your season, I guess. Well, I wouldn't go that far. They're still like an over 500 team. And of course, those injured players come back immediately. When you get hurt, you come back the next day. The fact that they got three guys hurt in three innings is one of the most extraordinary injury performances and outcomes that I've had in Strat. I don't recall three. I think I've had three injuries in a game before, but not in the first three innings. The Diamondbacks get the win. They're 8-6, hitting .271 with a .344 ERA. And Vegas has got to be kicking themselves. They fall to 10-9. Had a great chance to kind of take control of this division. They blew it. Woody Fryman was 4-0. have to wonder what would have happened had we just let him finish what he started. He was 4-0, and Woody Freeman's given up just 4 runs in 44 innings this year, folks. Are you wondering what that ERA is? I am. Yes, it's 0.81. So poor Woody Freeman. It's all probably going to go to the All-Star game with gaudy statistics like that. Misses out on his 5th win. He had 4 complete games, too, in 4 starts. Well, he had 4 complete games with 4 wins, I'll put it that way. He had 5 starts. So 10-9. We have played 244 games to this point. The league's hitting 260 with a 3.87 ERA. We will post the results of Game 5 in Arizona and then Games 6 and 7 in Las Vegas if necessary. Thanks for checking out this, and we'll see you next time. Well, baseball fans, some interesting stuff happened after, of course, the Game 4 comeback win by Arizona. 2-1 in the bottom of the 4th. Do they take momentum into Game 5, you're probably wondering? And the answer is, well, yeah. If momentum is such a thing, they certainly did. Because in Game 5, the final game in Arizona, 3-run homer in the 1st by Jim Lytle, 2-run shot by Ed Herman. They just keep piling on the runs. An 11-4 victory by number 4 starter Chuck Dobson, defeating the ace, Ray Culp. Worst start of the year for Ray. Getting knocked out. And Vegas suddenly looking pretty silly after once being up 3-0. Blowing 2 chances here in the Joshua Tree. So they have to come back home to the friendly confines of the Taj Mahal in Las Vegas. And in game number 6, Arizona is down to their number 5 starter, Chris Short, against Blue Moon Odom. Both pitchers really struggled in this game, but Short super struggled in comparison. 5 2/3 innings, 14 hits, 7 runs, only 3 charges earned. It's a 7-6 game, and then finally the bullpen of Vegas this time did the job. Jim Rowland and Jim York shut the door over the last 3 frames, something that Jim Rowland didn't do in the game you saw. He does it here. And so Vegas closes out Arizona at home in a Game 6. So congratulations, Las Vegas, the division winner a year ago, vanquishing the up-and-coming Arizona Diamondbacks 4-2 in the desert. Thanks for checking it all out. We'll see you next time.